Now I'd like to show you how the pushdown automaton we constructed in the last video processes words. And the definition says it works like a bottom-up LR parser, and it creates a rightmost derivation in reverse order. So it will be a little bit complicated, but I do my best to make it clear for you. So let me just draw the derivation tree first. The word for which I show you the whole thing will be A3D, and we get the word by expanding S to ABC. The B will be expanded to CD, and both of those C will be expanded to D's. So now I want to write for you the rightmost derivation in reverse order, and I will write it down from bottom to the top so that it will be in the right line for the with what's in the automaton happens at the same time. So let's just start with the start symbol, which we expand to ABC. Now in the rightmost derivation, we want to process first the non-terminals that are rightmost in the string, so in this case it's C. So in the next step, we want to replace that C by a D. And, well, let me draw write down the numbers for you. So first I exchanged the S by ABC, so I did the S first. Now I exchanged the C by a D, so I did the C next. I just write the numbers of the order for you to the derivation tree, so to make it clearer for you. Now I want to process the B and exchange it by CD. I have to write it down here. BCD. D, so I did the B as third, and now I want to exchange the C by the D, and I get A3Ds, and I did those C as fours. Now I show you how the automaton does the same thing. It will be a little bit complicated, and I show you only the successful steps. So at the beginning, the input string is A and 3Ds. On the stack, we have our bottom symbol, that's Z0. And we begin in state Q0. And that because we have to do a lot of things in Q0, that's the state. We will stay in the state for a while. So now what we can do is we want to use, let me have a look, we can use this rule where we want to read an A from the input string, we read Z0 from the stack, and we put those A and Z0 on the stack. So basically we are moving the A from the input string onto the stack. So we are left here with 3Ds, and the A moves to the stack. So that is exactly this A. Now we want to move again that D onto the stack, so we are left here with 2Ds, and 1D has moved to the stack. And as you can see in the derivation tree, that D will be reduced to a C. So we take, let me have a look, we take this transition where we read nothing from the input string, and we take we pop those D from the stack and replace it by a C. So this the word will stay the same, and we replace that D by a C. Now we want to move the next D onto the stack, so we are left with 1D at the input, and we have DC A Z0 on the stack. Now, as you can see here, we can reduce the C and the D to a B. And as you can see as well on the stack, we have D and C in reverse order. And that's why we have those rules in reverse order. So we can take this transition rule, where we read D and C from the stack and replace it by a B, which, well, it's nearly the same as this rule, as you can see, maybe. So the word stays the same, and we replace D and C by a B. And now we move that D onto the stack, so we are left with an empty input string, and the D, the last D, has moved to the stack. Now we reduce that D to a C again with that transition, and those epsilon on the rest input string will just stay there. So we reduce the D to a C. And now what we have here is exactly the same as from this rule, as expands to ABC. But just in reverse order. And that's why we have this transition where we can pop C, B, and A from the stack, and we can push the S, or we can reduce the 3 to the S. Doesn't matter how we want to say it. So we are left with the start symbol and that 0 on the stack. And now the last two transitions we can take is the one from Q0 to Q1, where we just pop the S from the stack and put nothing back. And we change from Q0 to Q1. And now we can take this transition from Q1 to Qf, where we pop the Z0 from the stack. And we are left with the empty stack and the full processed input string. So the automaton accepted the word. And now if you compare the rightmost derivation with the stack, well, you see here we exchanged the S by ABC. And here, well, as you can see, the S before has been ABC in reverse order. So what here we were expanding, and here is the same what we were reducing, and it's also in the same order reverse as the rightmost derivation. Or you can see here where we reduce the D to a C, that's what we had here, well, the other way around, where we exchange the C by a D. So the automaton indeed works like a rightmost derivation in reverse order, and I hope that this made it a little more clear for you.